Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis Blind. I just realized, well, figured out something, and I reloaded a save. Ran all the way back here. Let me just save now. Because I wanted to show you guys. Not just say, hey, I did this thing, I want to show you. Save. Alright, so. This is the thing I did. I couldn't find anything else. I'll put this here. Now I'm guessing this is to keep the door open. The wet towel is wound tightly into the cog mechanism. What? Come again? It sounded like a kid. What am I looking at? Oh. Why did it show up with a look thing? Okay. Toe tag then? And it'll stay open? It's gonna be uncomfortable for us.
Warning. Temperature increasing to dangerous level. The duty officer has been notified of equipment failure. Please evacuate area immediately.
Wow. Wow, our first death. I'm so proud. Alright. Glad I just saved for that. Wait. What did it do? Auto-save me? Wait, 4-4. It saved over? Did I hit save? Oh hell. Be back. Okay, so let's do this and not die horribly. Like, leave the area. That should be easy enough. Okay. Just want to look at something. Okay. I might have hit save instead. I don't know. Alright, so toe tag and make tracks. Go.
Warning.
Go.
Temperature increasing today.
Oh god.
Can imagine. Oh, I guess it burned what do you call it? The notes. Did I even read this? Unlike many other surfaces in the facility, the autopsy table is surprisingly clean. The stains of previous autopsies are only faintly visible on the slab. The cold surface of the mortuary slab sits undisturbed. What if we disturb it? Can't actually do anything with that. A cold, hard mortuary slab. The jaws of the cremation furnace are sealed shut. Cadaver. The bones make a rough sketch of the human form. Female? Cadaver? An unbearable stench rises from the rotting corpse. I think this is what we want. Yep, large crowbar. The one shape, human shape of the cadaver now resembles a lump of decaying meat. The crowbar is lodged firmly in this cadaver's head. Cool.
Oh, God.
And maybe not so cool.
I can hear you're taking strain. But keep your eyes on the end goal. Your family. We need you.
Never mind, I haven't told her what the hell I'm doing up here. Alright, so now we got a crowbar. We still have an empty hypodermic syringe. And the high-speed neural drill. The toe tag, I guess we didn't need anymore. And the, towel. Unfortunately. They tell you not to go without your towel. We don't have one now. It's gone as well. Probably burned a bit. And so, back down to level one? No, level two.
So once I get this tram working, where do I go?
Your best bet is to find medical access terminal. The medical wing is on that tram line, so it should be a quick ride.
Thank you, Tia. And, I'm sorry about your friend.
Just be safe.
Yeah. I'll try. I don't know what's waiting for me over here. Or anywhere. Crowbar. The lock on the middle cover broken, the tram line breaker box lies open. Gordon Freeman would be proud. Tram line breaker. Okay, this is one, right? Do we not want one? I think we wanted two. If that's a one. Break this one open too? Tram charging system. Oh. Okay, so one's the charging system. And this is just general power? Tram charging breakers are exposed. Tram line breaker. Alright, so we just need to switch them both on. Probably in a certain order, which I'm not aware of. What am I doing? How do I... What do I do? Oh, right! We need to take them one out of... Okay, won't put any other. Got it. Fuse. Well, I need to... get up close and personal here. Well, give me my stuff. Can I... Okay. Can't use it in that screen? Okay. Do I have to do anything else? Does it switch anything on? I just put it in, and that's good? I guess so. That's the problem. Computer terminal. Okay, recharge tram. Oh my. That was quick.
Okay, the tram's power.
I see it. Give me a second.
It was like an Atari 2600 sound.
Send your destination from the medical wing.
Thank you. Do I have to switch the tram line? Two is out of order. Oh, they're both out of order. Do I need to put the other thing back? The tram line breaker bomb? See, now we're charged, right? Now do I put it back? Because I'm pretty sure only one was out of order before. There it is. Why I want to make sure it's there. Tram 2, line active. Switch tram line.
All done. Destination set. Start the tram to be on your way.
Please manually switch lines from internal tram control. Alright. Something gonna pop out at me now? Say, I'm really enjoying this. Tram active. Next station, Medical Bay, main lobby. Tramline switch. Awesome. We're on our way.
How long?
How long what?
How long ago was the evacuation? My family would have left with everyone else, with the people that made it out.
That's, I'm not sure exactly.
That blood looked pretty dry.
It's been a while. We've been stuck in this death trap for about 3 months now.
3 months?
Months?
There were four of us recently. You and I were the last. We were repairing the shuttles. It's radio to Lord Olsen. Sure, you were about getting supplies when... Well?
Was it you? I mean, were you and he?
Fury? No. We would have killed each other long ago if we didn't need each other to survive. I miss him, though. He got things done. I was married once. But that was a long time ago.
What happened?
Oh, how interference?
Many of your cockroaches do I have to kill for this?
Who's this?
Let's talk about this!
This was the last straw.
Malin?
I'm coming for you next.
Oh my.
As for your little head.
Warning. Brakes disabled. Low-pass filters disabled. Structural integrity compromised. And evacuation is advised.
Brakes disabled.
Tram.
Oh boy.
Yeah,
alright. Didn't have a chance to... Yeah, that wasn't too cool. Malin, huh? Really nice guy. Psychotic much? Oh. We broke through the floor? I'm assuming that was the tram coming down.
John? John! Are you okay? I've lost the tram signal!
Yeah, and I've lost the tram.
I can barely make you out.
Are you hurt?
Am I holding on to something?
I think I'm okay. I'm fine. I need to get out of this tram. It's okay. I think I can make the jump.
Jump!
Yep. jump. Nothing to look at, we're just gonna jump.
See where you are.
Just second.
Yeah, we're kinda busy right here. Made it. Oh crap.
That was close.
John, are you okay?
I'm fine. you're breaking up. I can't hear you. Hello? Tia? Come in. Radio's not working.
Knew we should have switched to T-Mobile.
First things first. Where the hell am I?
Down somewhere. What was that sprint? The tram has reached its last stop on the line. The sound of its unplanned parking procedure still rings in your head. Yeah, no kidding. Door to crash tram. You're lucky not to have been crushed by the flying wreck. Indeed. Leaking metal walls. An oily mixture runs in rivulets down the industrial prefab walls. Wonderful place to be. Debris. The tram's crash has left a menagerie of debris in its wake. Concrete, strips of metal, power lines, and a further mangled mess. Anything else to look at? So going in there. Yeah. Nylon emergency tape. This is why I look all over the place, so we're gonna pick that up. I'll have use of that for something.
I could use this.
Okay. Where are we here? The store has thankfully been left unlocked. A sizable, comprehensive toolbox has been abandoned here. An unremarkable poster has been tacked to the wall. Can't really see it.
2151. We left in 2148.
Oh.
3 years ago. These bastards had us here for 3 years.
Wow. The faded image of a woman smiles back at you from the water-damaged wall calendar. Empty metal boxes. Or PDA here. Alright, let's check out the toolbox and PDA.
Oh, shit. Where the hell am I gonna find the key in this mess?
This?
I think that will just break it.
Probably. And try this.
I don't think this will fit.
I'll drill it open. Break it open with the crowbar. Here we go. Gordon Freeman!
This ain't working.
Gordon Freeman hangs his head in dismay. Well, I don't know where we would find a key in this mess. Construction light. The glare of a portable standing light throws the room into stark contrast. So maybe we can't get anything, any kind of key just yet. Though a number of metal containers have been placed here, they currently hold nothing of use. Alright, this is PDA. Maybe the PDA says something about a key. Albert Olsen, engineer. August 19th, Kane certainly spared no expense on the engineering decks. More often than not, the air conditioning breaks faster than the maintenance can come back to fix it. The walk to the restrooms can exceed 10 minutes on a good day. It's of no consequence. With the lush retirement package Kane has prepared for me, I'd happily work in a cardboard box lined with thumbtacks for the rest of my career. I'm scheduled to receive my new heart and lungs within the next few months, at which point I may finally retire to join my wife, Rosalind, in Chicago. Until then, cigarettes and foods of the highest saturated fat content will continue to carry me through the day. Wow. Okay. He doesn't give a crap because he's getting new heart and lungs. Probably dead now anyway. Oh, I can mouse wheel. I didn't realize that. Yeah. Retirement package. That should be pretty sweet. Probably never got it. Probably was a lie to begin with. October 24th. This evening I was surveying the equipment on the decks when I noticed something rather unusual. A very fine layer of some sort of fungal substance is beginning to settle on the machinery. It's even found its way into the dials and monitors. They look filthy on the inside. Given the conditions around here, though, the growth of mold on any surface should come as no surprise. But it seems to be interfering directly with the performance of the Groomlake, so it's of some urgency that it's taken care of. I reported to Okay. Are you done? Kinda worried that something is there now. The sounds have never gone on for that long before. Okay, I reported it to maintenance. Hopefully they'll be quick in cleaning it up. Okay, so he's an engineer. Yeah, not maintenance. October 25th, next day. Kane Corporation must be pleased with my performance so far. I woke up to a promotion. I'm in charge of the construction of new cloning vats, effective immediately. I have little time to elaborate. This job is important and urgent, I believe. November 13th. I never anticipated that the project would be on such a huge scale. Clones will be created in mass quantities utilizing several megavats fitted with special equipment and an enrichment liquid to accelerate the growth process. I must enhance the rate at which we'll be creating clone batches. They've invented a method of manufacturing human beings faster than humans can biologically. Project Seed insists that the cloning vats are put to use immediately, despite the fact that they're far from complete. The vats can certainly sustain the cloning process, but some safety precautions are lacking. Like, the holding chambers for research clones have no power routed to them, so the electronic locks are useless. The walkways above the vats are still only temporary. O'Sullivan fell over the guardrail and into a vat yesterday. Had it not been filled with sanitizing solution, we would have lost him. Oh, crap. So what is this about the vats? I'm gonna have to mess with that. The vats... they have no power, so electronic locks are useless. The walkways are temporary. Trying to make a mental note of this stuff. I'm, like, exiting out to see the dates, guys, because it's not in the actual entry. The clones appear to operate entirely on instinct. November 29th. One of the complete human clones in Vat Theta bit a good chunk out of Miss Keen's ear during feeding time. Blech. Oh my god. No wonder they have a good retirement package. They must pay a lot. It's really hazardous to work here. November 30th. Three of the completed research clones tore through their holding chamber's analog locks last night over in the labs. They found Peters bent over backwards with his head between his knees. He's not going to be walking again anytime soon. Oh my god. Was he dead? Maintenance will be fixing the electronic locks this evening. O'Sullivan has asked to be assigned to a different project. O'Sullivan. Is that Peters? December 1st. O'Sullivan's request was denied. Keen, however, has been transferred to Project Seed. December 5th. I've been stealthily increasing the portions of food. to Elon's batch. Elon Musk? In Vat 449. Although they're just hearts and lungs, I can't help but feel an attachment. Really? Additionally, we've noticed a mass of organic matter that has sprouted a tail and swims around aimlessly. O'Sullivan wants to name it after his mother-in-law. Who in their right mind names a defective clone? So O'Sullivan must be someone else. Peters must be dead. He's bent over backwards. He had that on traction for the rest of his life. December 6th. Samantha, the impossible human fish monstrosity, crushed Elon with her thrashing as she was being removed from her vat. Most of the other clones in the batch have similar deformities. None of them actually grew into heart and lung tissue as they were meant to do. In fact, the results thus far are truly horrifying. Do tell. December 14th. Everyone has been acting strangely lately. O'Sullivan didn't show up this week, leaving me to tend to the vats by myself. I don't understand why this being permitted, but management would have most certainly dragged him down here by the cheeks if there was no legitimate justification. Speaking of cheeks, one of the complete human clones took a chunk out of mine when I was escorting it to the research labs. Holy crap. December 19th. The Groomlake has been completely locked down. A massive tremor shook and collapsed the walkways over the cloning vats. I'm trapped. I can't access the bulkhead. If this lockdown is anything like I heard the last one was, it should be over soon enough. Hopefully sooner rather than later. Two packs of cigarettes will only last for so long. So he's trapped in with the cloning vats, who like to attack people. December 27th. I can hear screams of terror through the ceiling. They echo. Each reverberation is a reminder that I'm damn fortunate to be down here and not up there. Although my supplies are running out, I sincerely hope that I don't have to swim for it. If the clones don't get me, cardiac arrest from the aerobic exercise will. Oh, jeez. Hopefully he's more worried about the clones. December 31st. I'm going to attempt to swim across Vat Theta. I'll reach the other side and try to get myself to the next level of the ship. Clones have been violently floundering in the growth liquid. Given what they did to Peters, I might not see the other side of this vat. The remainder of this story is to be delivered to my wife. She's like off. For Rosalind. Same date. Rosalind, I can only hope they have the opportunity to deliver this to you myself. If not, I must attempt to express with words what I have longed to convey physically. Should I die before I can get off this vessel, every moment of my life, every cumulative experience that has influenced my being, will scream your name, begging the reality of inevitable death to spare me, if only to touch you once more. I apologize for, and regret, every second I have spent away from you. Until that moment we first met, my heart was a void, lacking the fierce fires of passion that you have bestowed within. No matter the outcome of my escape, I will be long dead before they are extinguished. For an eternity after I have perished, you will live on. Your name will ring out throughout the galaxy, a testament to all of existence that there can never exist a love greater than what I have for you. Your love is my life. As such, I am immortal. Aww. Actually, really touching, and I'm willing to bet he did not survive. Alright, so what's here? Clones? Vats? I'm not looking forward to that. Is that one of the clones? What was that? What's with the long loading screens now? Oh, brother.
Tia, I don't know if you can hear me, but I'm in some sort of...
Where is he? Oh.
I'm not sure what to call it.
A part of you wishes the door had been locked. You're no kidding. construction light. Unlike its partner, this floodlight sits in silence, projecting no illumination. Electricity pole. The electricity pole serves the vital function of keeping high-voltage electrical cables away from the liquid-filled vats. Well, you know what we have to do? We have to electrify...
Something's moving in there.
Whatever the hell this
Five.
Stuff is. Before we try to cross it, which is what he should have done. Generator. A generator rig hums softly. Construction light. A heavy-duty floodlight has been positioned on this platform, possibly to assist in construction work. Destroyed crosswalk. The crosswalk that once spanned this vat has collapsed and is now covered by a rippling lagoon of flesh. There he is. The marks on this engineer's corpse leave little doubt that parts of the body have been eaten, although it's not clear whether consumption occurred before or after death. Half-formed clone. Bodies grown for research, sale, or other unimaginable purposes. Bloody handprints. A long smear form a pair of bloody handprints streaked downward into the vats, as if someone were dragged into the bubbling morass. Oh my god, so he almost made it? There's another one. The flesh has accreted in irregular clumps throughout the vat, forming hairy, muscular... It left before I could finish reading. How rude. Cloning vat organic sludge. Some portions of the biological broth are thick and viscous, clotted with parts, and other sections swirl more smoothly in elaborate mandalas. There it is. Muscular hillocks that have given birth to truncated limbs and torsos. Lovely. Same description here. Darkness? I attack the darkness. The darkness pervades ever deeper, concealing the size of the chamber. I want to see what happens if I just run out into this. Should I? Can I? Sorry guys, I just had to see it. Plus, I want to see something.
2151. They left in 2148.
Yes,
3 years ago. These bastards had us here for 3 years.
I know. Let me hit escape and... So, I must have saved, but load. Okay. Yeah, creepy stuff. Clone vats. Alright, so stay tuned for our next episode when we... I guess we're gonna... That's what I'm gonna try to do. Rig up this generator to kill everything in here so we can traverse safely. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.